It's still spinning.
Holy moly.
Big game. Let's see if Coot can land it.
Rolls in.
What do you think it is?
Big crappie.
Anything? How's it feel?
Feels like a fish. Big fish, here it comes. Get the gaff. Do something. Holy moly, it has to be a northern. He took so much line out. Ooh, Jesus.
He ran for days.
I guess so.
It has to be maybe a bass.
Oh my gosh! Look at that. Oh, go get the tape measure. Can you go grab that bucket real quick?
Ooh, baby.
Can you grab that bucket?
I think what's happening, these crappies are hitting that bait and they're running because they don't want to be caught with the mineral hanging out.
No.
Look at that mouth.
Wow.
Have you ever caught a crappie that big?
Yeah, it's a big crappie.
All right, what'd you get?
Well, we got a nice crappie here. Thanks to Vic. Look at the line this thing took all. It almost acted like a northern. So we're gonna
measure
this thing quick and get it back in a hole for her.
Have you ever caught a crappie that big tonight?
I don't think so. Even trolling, I've never caught a crappie that big. I can't remember how big we got that one at home.
What do you think? Oh, what do you guys think?
I'm going to guess 15.
I'll say 14 and a half, 15.
12. Come on. Come on.
Oh, baby.
14. Four. 14 and a half.
That was pretty close. That was half off.
Nice fish.
There we go.
Get a release.
Here she goes.
Nice job. Woo-hoo. Might want to sit. Look at that.
Ta-da. This is lunchtime, a little slow on the fishing, so we got Anthony here from the Garage Gourmet. He's actually cooking for us, so what do we got going?
Well, you know, when it's this cold, the propane grills, they just don't cut it.
Yep.
So I brought my little Weber Smokey Joe here, and I got some bratwurst going.
Oh.
I got some kraut warming up right there. I grilled these so they didn't pop the casings. You know, slowed my charcoal down. I got a nice toasted bun here. We'll grab Coot a nice brat there. Look at that. You a kraut guy?
Well, we'll try some kraut.
A little warmed up the kraut.
Need a little gas for it right
home. Oh, yeah. You want some onion on there?
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
A little onion.
Ta-da.
And then I got mustard and ketchup if you want any of that.
We'll go for this right now.
Oh.
Baby, that looks good.
So, you know, if you want to make everybody on the ice jealous, you bring a grill along and you cook something out. It tastes better on a cold day.
Ow. It's a little warm, but it's good stuff, man.
Mustard and ketchup right there. So,
what was I eating before?
Venison bacon. That's
venison bacon. That's some awesome
cooked
stuff.
Up some venison bacon there on there. So we got a little piece of that right there as an appetizer.
Yummy.
We'll probably put that right on the bun with the brat here. You know, bacon, brat, kraut.
Good stuff. I can see we're going to fish with Anthony some more. He's got a good cook.
The food.
Yeah, the good food stuff.
If the fish aren't biting, we will. We're going to be biting into this.
Yep.
So just an ordinary guy in an ordinary world cooking above ordinary food for much above ordinary people.
And what's the other saying you say? Never trust a skinny chef. You believe that? Come on.
I'm not serving salad out here. We're going for meat and brats. I mean,
yeah,
come on.
Woo-hoo.
And if you could just smell that.
That's a good stuff.
That smell of a grill and the ice cold. When your neighbor's got your grill out and you smell that in the wintertime, you know what makes you jealous.
That's right.
So
I hear you.
If you're going to watch the Packer game tonight,
yep.
Fire up your grill. Come on, make your neighbors jealous.
Yeah.
So
tailgate in the backyard.
Absolutely. So all thanks right. for checking us out for a little bonus Garage Gourmet on the ice.
Let's go fishing. Well, I can't do much ice fishing, so I thought I'd give you a couple tips here. I love my Polar Fire hard case for my rods and reels. It protects them very much so. So my little trick is, I want to show you chip clips to protect your lures. You know, you go to the dollar store, it's an easy fix for any size lure to protect it from getting all messed in your case. So check out some chip clips. So that's my pro tip for today. So check it out. Let's go fishing. HD Enterprises. we're in Fort Wayne, Indiana, setting up in the War Memorial Coliseum here. We got our booth all set up for this weekend. It's going to be Friday, Saturday, Sunday, so come out, give us a talk. And there's a lot of boats here, there's a lot of trucks, a lot of cars, a lot of campers, a lot of stuff out here. So if you're bored this weekend, come on out, because you can't go ice fishing. There ain't no ice down here. Let's go fishing. Ashton checking out the hole here today. What do you think of that, Ashton, huh? Let's see, we're going to pull the fish out of the tube here. And we go ice fishing, yeah. That neat? All right, we'll get you out. Here we go, up.
Well, what did you vote?
I don't know yet. I think I'm going to leave it the way it is, try it for quite a while, and we'll go from there. What would really be cool, if we could design something that slides across here when you bring up the fish and you close it, and you trap the fish without even going down the hole, but I don't know, that would take some engineering. We'll see. I've done a catch cover in my Can-Am Defender. I think I did a pretty good job. So now I got a question for you guys. If you've ever done this, I want to know a little secret if possible. So I'm going to pull this off. Now I got this tube here. This is cool. Do I leave it that high and push it into the snow? I know when I get on glare ice, it's going to stay up that high. But I just wonder if I should cut off that 2 inches to make it flush, that sits on the floor. I don't know, but I like some opinion, so please help me out here, okay? Let's go fishing.
Who's talking? You're talking, right?
I'm talking.
Hey, I'm just showing HG stuff. These guys right here are doing a crappie junction. Check them out. They fish a lot of crappies. They know their stuff. They interview a lot of people. They have a lot of great fishing knowledge and all that, so follow these two right here.
Where can we find you guys?
You can find us at crappiejunction.com. Crappie Junction on Facebook, Crappie Junction. Just type Crappie Junction into Google and you'll see everything that we do.
And Emily, you got the closing words.
If we don't see you here, then hopefully we see you out on the ice.
All right.
Well, we got the rescue throw bag from HT. This is a 50-foot rope, 3/8 thickness. So I'm going to demonstrate how I want to show you to set this up. So you got a strap here, you got a little cord to pull it out. So when you want to throw it, you want to open this up a little bit. So I have a bowline knot here. So now I'm going to make a half hitch. I'm going to slip my wrist and we're going to cinch this up on my wrist like this, okay? So when you want to throw this bag, you want to throw with the strap and you want to throw as hard as you can down there. So I'm going to try to get real close to Chad. So he's my victim today. So here we go.
Whoa.
There you go. That's what you want to do, is get that out to the person, get a little safety rope to hang on to, and hopefully you can pull that person out. So in the next video, I'm going to show you how to put it back in the bag. It's really simple. So there you go. So after deploying the bag, we're going to go get the bag and we're going to put it all back together.
So how far about was that?
Well, it's a 50-foot bag. We'll see what's left in the bag here. So here we go. There you go. All but a foot and a half. Not too bad of a throw. So we're going to open up the bag here, that lanyard. Now to help put this on, put this over your shoulder. And now we're just going to stuff it in like this as you walk by. Okay? It's just so simple. For a retail $25 to $30, it's a great safety tool to have along. And if you're board fishing, have the kids practice throwing it into a bucket. So at least they have an idea how to do it. And then show them how to stuff it back in. So have fun on the ice. Hopefully you never have to use this. I actually carry one in my boat. And I actually towed a boat in with it. It was really cool. It worked out and the guy bought one for me.